completely paralyzed by the need to perform an irrational ritual. They wash their hands repeatedly, lock the door 5 times, count to 7 before entering a room, just to get through the day, or even the hour. They suffer from obsessive compulsive disorder, a crippling anxiety disorder. OCD is twofold.
Of the Anxiety Disorder Center at the Institute of Living. So, Dr. Tolan, who's at greatest risk for this very perplexing problem?
Well, Dr. Oz, the number one risk factor is people with a family history of OCD. We know that there's a very strong genetic component. Mm-hmm. It seems to affect men and women in about equal numbers, although boys seem to develop this disorder earlier, whereas girls tend to develop in later teenage or even early adulthood years.
Yeah. Now, I've always been fascinated by this because it seems like it's a sort of a kink in the normal machinery of the brain. So let me show you an animation of how the brain processes information. And we're just beginning to learn this now. So deep inside the brain, there's a place called the worry circuit. It's where we all think about things. And it takes us from the prefrontal cortex, the very front part of our brain, deep inside the brain, to an area called the caudate nucleus. That's the red area here. This is the cingulate gyrus. The names are unimportant, but they're now be the frontier of where we now understand, we figure out the consequences of our actions. We form habits because of that, because we predict the future. It's wonderfully effective in living life, but what if it short circuits?
There are two main symptoms of OCD. The first is what we call obsessions. These are unwanted thoughts, ideas, images, or impulses that come into the mind again and again, and the person can't get rid of them. And so one of these might be, for example, an excessive preoccupation with dirt or germs or contamination, an idea that everything is germy and going to hurt you. Another might be an excessive worry about harming other people, maybe by making a mistake, such as leaving the oven on, or maybe on purpose by doing something violent that they don't mean to do. Mm-hmm. Another might be a need for things to be ordered or symmetrical, right, or lined up just so that everything has to be perfect, otherwise things feel like they're out of control. And then there are some people who have obsessions that are personally repugnant, sexual or religious or violent thoughts or images. Mm-hmm. These are the obsessions.
Hot. It is a crippling and mysterious disease that makes everyday life a minefield for some 5 million Americans. OCD, or obsessive compulsive disorder. And one of those people is superstar comedian Howie Mandel. On stage, he makes millions of people laugh, but off stage, he can't shake hands with them, or touch a doorknob, or a glass, or even be with his own family at times. Here's David Muir.
It's 7 o'clock in the morning, and Howie Mandel arrives at the set of Deal or No Deal.
First trick of the day.
Almost immediately, glimpses of the Howie Mandel that he's kept secret for most of his career.
Handrails are my enemy. I never go near a handrail. I won't open those things. I would never serve myself. I wouldn't touch this because a lot of people have touched that. This is actually my nightmare.
Mandel has obsessive compulsive disorder, OCD.
I love this. Every door should just push out.
His obsession, germs, an obsession made famous with his trademark fist bump.
And what's the difference between shaking the hand and the fist bump?
In my mind, this is a petri dish. Otherwise, I would spend the day, as I have in the past in my life, in the men's room, rubbing and scrubbing and scalding.
But as we were about to learn, Howie Mandel's OCD goes far beyond that fist bump. Offstage, it is all-consuming.
Look, everything's brand new each day. That's normally how a workstation looks. Look at my stuff. It's all brand new, not touched.
Even Mandel's trademark bald head is this way by choice.
This feels so streamlined and so clean. You know, it feels cleaner.
Not even 8:30 in the morning, and we've barely scratched the surface. Mandel has written a new book called Here's the Deal, Don't Touch Me, revealing his, at times, crippling struggle with OCD.
It's uncomfortable, and it's hard, and it's somewhat embarrassing. There were many times when I wanted to back out. I'm not somebody who sits down with strangers as I sit here.
We go way back.
But it's not even you, it's them.
Mandel's fans would never know just how deep it goes. Until now, the audience had only heard this.
Howie Mandel does not shake hands, okay?
Howie
you
Mandel
either knuckle
does not
him,
shake.
You can hug him.
You can knuckle him, you just can't shake his hands.